evening, everyone. My name is Darden Rice, and I'm running for St. Pete City Council District 4. And I think if there's one neighborhood that really exemplifies what can be accomplished with spirited, motivated neighborhood leaders working in tandem with a responsive city hall, that example has to be historic Kenwood and the Grand Central Business District, which is actually, even though you're not in my technical district, it is one of my favorite places in the city, and I think it's one of the places that makes St. Pete, St. Pete. And I am a longtime resident of St. Petersburg. I've been here a little over 20 years, and I've been a homeowner just almost as long. I am a graduate of Eckerd College, Harvard of the South. And I am also very glad to tell you that, and proud to tell you that I have the official endorsement of Councilmember Jeff Danner in this race. And I'm also glad to count a number of the neighborhood leaders and the movers and shakers who have helped build Kenwood from the bottom up for all these years as some of my best friends and supporters. So when it comes to District 4, you have an ally with me for Kenwood and the Grand Central Business District. I won my primary. I won a four-way race in the primary with 46% of the vote. And now we're citywide, so you can vote your choice of mayor and in all the districts 2, 4, 6, and 8. I have the longest record of public service in my race. I helped start the Green Cities program back in 2005. I was the president of the League of Women Voters of St. Pete for 3 years. I was one of the co-founders, along with Carl Nurse, of the Pinellas Living Green Expo. I served on the Charter Review Commission, and in that capacity, I was also chair of the Waterfront Subcommittee, where we started first putting together our plans for the downtown waterfront plan. I currently serve on PSTA, and I agree with comments from Councilmember Kennedy that I think mass transit and transportation is the number one issue facing our future. And I'm one of the leaders of our Green Light Pinellas campaign. And I'm more than happy to stay afterwards and answer any questions you have about what the referendum means and what the changes in mass transit are proposed. I'm a big advocate for all of it. My plan for St. Pete is called St. Pete Strong. And it's based on three pillars of strong economy, strong neighborhoods, and strong city services. You can find out more details about my plan on my website at votedardenrice.com. And from the very beginning of my race, I have strived to present my plan to voters and really to run my campaign just like a smart business. And I never envisioned getting into this race of just trying to raise enough money to beat another person. Instead, I ran on my plan, and I have focused on sticking to my plan called St. Pete Strong. And unlike my opponent, I have never spent a dime on going negative in this race, nor do I plan to. And that's how I roll. I plan, I prepare, I focus on goals, and more importantly, I focus on results and outcomes. I stay positive, and I cooperate with everyone. And that's why I'm glad to have such wide support from unions that represent city workers to business leaders, from Republicans to Democrats. I'm pretty fortunate that I've had the opportunity to marry my love of this state and its people and its environment with the big economic issues that challenge us now and in the future. I have a strong background, years of policy expertise and experience dealing with clean water rules, both state and national, healthcare policy, transportation, and I even spent a few years designing municipal models for energy efficiency. And that all bears on city issues. One of the city's biggest responsibilities is guaranteeing delivery of clean water supply and managing waste. The cost of running our buildings and fleets is a factor in our budget. And critically, our health care costs have risen 16%. So I know how to look at those policies and expenses and know how to come up with better solutions and savings. My career as an organizational leader, a person who leverages strong relationships, strong business management, and leadership skills, coupled with my work ethic and persistence, I have the innovation to get things done with big impacts. By necessity, my work in nonprofits has required that I drive high efficiency outcomes on limited resources. I'm a powerful leader in a team environment. And if there's one thing City Council needs, it's stronger leaders who know how to work cooperatively with a team and know how to work with the mayor's side of City Hall. Business leaders recognize this also. And that's why unions support me. It's why business groups who have scrutinized my...
Please wrap in 30 seconds.
Got it, thank you. And why businesses who have scrutinized my background, leadership, and vision have endorsed me in this race. Public safety is also something extremely important facing our neighborhoods. I'm proud to tell you I've been officially endorsed by our firefighters and police, as well as other endorsements from Stonewall Democrats to both of the newspapers in the Tampa Bay area. The most important endorsement is you, and I look forward to talking to you more and earning your support to be your next city councilwoman for District 4. Thank you very much.